and welcome to Innovation Oxford. I'm your host, Michael Harding. You may have driven by these kinds of fields that are behind me all over Oxford County and may not have known what they are. They're soybean. And today, we're going to look at how soybean from Oxford County ends up on the world's dinner table.
That's the bean.
Bob, tell us a little bit about what brought your family to this area and a bit of the history.
Okay. My grandfather bought this farm in 1927. It was just a couple years before my dad was born, and obviously the 20s and 30s were very difficult times for farming. It was a mixed farm operation with dairy and swine, and he was producing some seed wheat. And it was an interesting story. My grandmother worked on a seed sample of wheat for the Chicago World's Fair in the late 1930s. And sent the sample in and actually won first prize. And the prize was a very substantial amount of money. I think it was $300 or $400, which was a huge amount of money in the 1930s. And that allowed them, there was enough money to allow them to keep the farm. So our history in the seed industry goes back a long ways.
There is more than one business here, isn't there?
There are three businesses here. There's Hart Home Farms is a cash crop operation. We have AgWorks, which is a seed cleaning and food grade soybean processing business, and we have a company called Proceeds of Canada, which we're a shareholder of, which is a marketer and distributor of soybean seed and genetics.
You're going to take us on a tour?
I am.
Let's go.
Okay.
And so what is this actually doing today?
This machine, we're cleaning and treating seed wheat today. The machine's not running actually right now, but it's a sifting. It sorts by size and by density, so it goes through a series of air blasts to lift up the lighter material, and then sizing the small stuff, shake through or scalp the big stuff off the top. This is a much more sophisticated plant than this one. Much more sophisticated.
Yeah.
This is the one we started with, and it worked because we did it on the cheap. You know, we did all the work ourselves. We built a lot of the equipment ourselves. My brother's extremely good at it, and then this one. This new one works because we spent a ton of money on it, and everything's all computerized and mechanized.
Well, isn't that the idea behind a startup? Get started, keep your overheads as low as possible, build your market.
That's exactly right.
Yeah, Bob, tell us what this equipment is doing.
Okay, the one right behind you, this is an automatic bagger. So you can see it picks up the bags, it pulls them through, and then there's suction cups open up the bag. The seed is weighed out in the scale above, and it drops in and reforms the gusset of the bag, and then ships it out. And then the fellow there is directing it into the sewing machine. Usually we have to sew a tag on. This particular customer doesn't want a tag. He would normally be putting a tag on at the same time. And it comes up and it's flattened. And then it goes across to the robot. And the key to making the robot work is to present every bag to it exactly the same way. That's the reason for the flattener and everything. Every bag has to come in exactly the same, stop in exactly the same spot. Because all the robot knows is when the sensor goes off, it's to come down and close the jaws and come over to the appropriate spot.
And how much productivity has improved as a result of this installation?
We had about a 45% increase in productivity, and it reduced our manpower from 5 guys to 1.5 guys to do the same.
And what is it you're packaging here?
These are food-grade soybeans going to Japan for use for making tofu.
Soybean like this arrived here in Oxford County in the 30s and then grew to be a crop for crushing, for oil, and for feed for animals as well. Until today, it is a food grade product that is harvested and processed here at AgWorks north of Woodstock on Highway 59.
So Bob, this looks like the computerized brains of your plant here. Tell us a little bit about it.
That's right. This computer controls everything in the plant and with the elevator outside. So. This is a schematic of the grain elevator outside. When a truck arrives with a variety, we tell it what variety we've got, and then it automatically sets all the spouts and pipes and everything, so it goes to the right bin. So we can't. It's very important to us that we keep each variety separate. So unless we lie to it, we can't dump the wrong beans in the wrong bin. And then the same for processing. When it's time to process, we say which variety we want to clean and which bin it's in and which processes we want to do, which bins we want to fill, and then it just takes over and just keeps on running until it's done, then shuts itself off.
And you run this plant 7/24?
That's right. You at least 6/24, quite often 7/24. And it runs by itself all night. The computer just looks after everything.
Do you get an email when something goes wrong?
No, I don't, but Nathan, our plant manager, has he can control it all from his iPhone.
This machine is called a color sorter, and it takes the beans through and has cameras that look at every bean, and if the beans don't meet the color specifications that we enter into the machine, then it has a little air blast that pokes them out, and that's what it's taking out.
So, and again, this goes on to Hamilton for crushing.
That's right. These are there's nothing wrong with these beans, they just have a different color.
So why are the Japanese so fussy about their food?
They are very particular about their food. I think that they have been through some hard times that a lot of people in our generation in this country have never been through. And they are very particular. They want to know where everything came from. They come here to visit. They want to see our facility. They want to meet the growers. They want to see the fields. They want us to have records, like we can go back and show where every ton of beans came from. We have a traceability right back to the farm. And it's all very important to them. And they're very willing to pay to have all that information. So we're glad to provide it.
Now, shape and size is really important in terms of cooking, isn't it?
It's very important in terms of cooking. And it's mostly most of the process with beans involve soaking. And they want the beans to all be the exact same size and shape without any cracks. So they all imbibe water at the same rate.
How's the market been? Are you making money?
Yeah, we're making some money. This has been a kind of a difficult year, though, for a couple of reasons. The Japan is our main market, and the Japanese economy is having a real struggle. The tsunami hit Japan. That did not help us at all. And it was a disaster for them. You know, it made a bad economy a lot worse. Apparently, a lot of migrant workers left Japan when the tsunami hit, a couple of 100,000 from Tokyo alone, and they would all be traditional tofu eaters, you know, so that's our market. There's been an oversupply situation in food-grade soybeans in the last couple of years in the world, and I think that's starting to come to an end now, but it's been a bit of a struggle.
Would you say that this is a traditional family farm?
No, this part of it is really not a farm at all, what we're doing right here. Like we do farm aside from all of this, but this is a process facility. So,
would you, without this kind of modification to the operation here, would you still be here?
I think that we would still be farming. Our farm would look very different than it does today. We actually scaled back on the farming 4 or 5 years ago now. We sold some land because we found we were just too busy. We had quite a chunk of land in the Embro area, and when it's time to plant corn or beans, it's time to plant corn and beans.
Right.
And our problem was we also had to process beans that day, and we got containers that got a train ticket to the West Coast, and they can't miss the train. So you have to make some decisions. And our decision was to cut back a little bit on the farm. And we still farm about 1,300 acres.
Well, that's not exactly small, is it?
No, but it's not big by any standards anymore.
AgWorks is another success story right here in Oxford County, whose identity preserved soybean is putting tofu on Japanese tables. And when we come back, we're going to look at another seed producer who's pioneering in their field. We'll be right back.